are here today with the fabulous Jamie D. Hello, Jamie.
Hello, Nikki.
Not your first time here.
No, second time.
Second time here. So the last time you came was to talk about the Olivier Awards.
It was. The last time, I think it was we were doing Hand to God.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right, yeah. That was fun.
Yeah.
Great show.
Yeah.
So, Jamie, you're here today to talk about your show at the Crazy Fox, which is happening very soon.
Sunday, we open.
Can you just tell us a bit about it?
Well, Alex Parker, who some of you might know, is a great young musical director, and I've worked quite a lot with him. He's asked me to do concerts of Little Night Music, and we did a production of putting it together at the St. James's, which is now called the Upper Palace. And it was always such great fun to work with him. And when I was doing Follies, he came to see it, and then afterwards we were having a drink, and he said, I'd really like to do a cabaret with you, but I'd like to go really slowly, and put loads of different sort of things in it, and new stuff. And I have to be honest to say, despite his painting of this slow, easy time, sitting down, looking at songs, and you know, it's not quite like that because we're both really busy, but
yeah,
we have had more time than I usually spend looking at numbers, and I'm very excited to, and actually terrified as well, that Sunday is not going to be what I've done before. I've got a couple of favourites in there because I know that some of the people who will come will want those, but overall, it's a very different cabaret to the one I have been doing recently, to the one that my CD is of, which is JDD at the BBC, which I did last time.
Yes, and
we'll be doing again. But this cabaret is a bit more Sondheim-y, if I'm really honest, and it just felt right at the moment because I've been so involved with him with Follies, and it felt like I was in the zone of Sondheim. But also for my life right now. Wherever I am, my cabaret is sort of going to reflect it.
Yeah.
I'm not feeling quite as jokey at the moment, but I don't think it's going to be a sad cabaret, but there is some darker moments in
it. And obviously, talk about Friends for a minute.
Yeah, sure.
That happened. You were in it.
Amazing.
It was absolutely fantastic. Yeah. And now this week, you found that you've been nominated for an Olivier Award. Another one.
Yes, it's very, very, very exciting and joyful to be invited to the party.
Does it get any less exciting? Did you kind of go, oh no,
another
one? Really?
Yeah, as you get older as well, you kind of, you have to get it straight in your head why you're doing what you do. You know?
Yeah.
And so, I really know why I do this now.
Mm-hmm.
I actually love doing it.
Yeah.
And I feel like I've learned a lot over the years. And right now it's all sort of coming together. Particularly when I did Follies, I felt, gosh, I really do know what I'm doing. I feel like I know what I'm doing. And, you know, if you've got all these amazing people around you, which was the case with Follies, they'll lift your game again. So, it was an amazing experience like that to know that I was coming as a mature, grown-up student to the table, but I had the best professors around me to, you know, raise it again. And that's what Follies felt like. It felt like we were reaching for something even better.
It was absolutely stunning.
Thank you. I'm so proud to have been a part of it.
If the opportunity came to do it again, would you? There was a twinkle in the eye, everybody.
we have actually been asked to do it again, and as I said to Dominic, I feel there's a little bit more to be mined from it and from Phyllis. So yes, I'm happy to do it again.
Excellent, that's great news. Very, very pleased to hear that. You've had a stunning career as well, which has taken you all around the world.
Yes.
And you've done stuff on Broadway. Any highlights, or is it difficult to choose?
I mean, going to New York both times, last year with Linda and the time before with Comic Potential, was sort of a dream come true, but both times much, much harder work than I had envisaged, than I had preempted. they're very serious about the work out there, and they're different to us. But here we cajole people and inspire, and there it's much more sort of insistent and edgy, I would say. There is the love. Oh my God! I mean, the people I was working with, you know, are still my friends, and there's so much team spirit in New York, probably because the pressure from producers and directors is far more overwhelming than it is here. Here, we have a sort of unbelievable support and belief and sort of faith.
Mm.
Not always rightly, I suppose. You know, you could say that. But I mean, I think that's a better way to handle people than maybe to get sort of punchy with them and, you know, forceful. At least that's my experience of it. And yeah, both times I found it invigorating in another sort of way to be in New York and be sort of knocked into shape.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was a bit like being punched into shape.
Really?
Yeah, it was, yeah. Whereas here, I felt like I was a piece of material that was being made bit by bit into the shape of Phyllis until it was all done inside and out.
Yeah.
Carefully stitched, gently, you know.
Yeah. That's really, it's amazing the difference, isn't it?
Mm. I quite like both.
Yeah, but, it must be great to be able to experience both.
It is. And to, you know, try and keep yourself steady in the middle of it all. Yeah.
A lot of our followers are, we've got a lot of followers that are aspiring performers.
Right.
Do you have any sort of advice for them?
Yes.
People getting into the business or people who want to get into the business?
Work hard. Persevere, and you will succeed. I said that to my sister, and we have both had this long career from the age of sort of 18 to, well, I'm now 55, so that's a pretty steady career. That's the way we've both kept ourselves alive, but also sane. So it's very important, I think, mental health, sanity, to know what makes you feel good. And what makes me feel good is knowing that I did a ballet class, you know, earlier today. That's why I'm dressed like this, sorry. not very glamorous. But anyway, I was working out basically in the ballet studio, and that makes me feel so much better than not having done it. Doing my warm-up every day, my singing warm-up is great. You know, the training never stops, and I think that's what I would say to everybody who's really sure that they want to do it. Just keep training and keep going and creating things yourself, because it's great if somebody offers us a job, but sometimes you could just not be offered something, obviously. And if you've got a little project on the go, something that you really care about, and it could be political or it could be just something a bit crazy, as long as it's something you want to do and really care about and you feel it's worth sharing with others, that can sustain you whilst you're doing your workout, waitressing or whatever. I used to waitress, sometimes worked in an office, but the problem with working in an office when I was younger was that you were sitting down, getting, you know, no workout, whereas strutting around as a waitress, you know, you're also chatting to people, you also get fed.
Yeah.
That's great. So, young, up-and-coming, musical theatre and all performers. That is my overall advice, but also to stay in touch with who you are and what you feel is the right way, because we all make our own journeys. You probably have other answers. These are my answers for me, but you might have other answers.
Right, we've got some questions actually that have been sent.
Right.
So let's have a look. What is your favourite show?
God, Night in the Piazza, I think, at the moment.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I really love the music and I love the place of it. Not just the fact it's in Florence in Italy, but I just love the understanding, the psychological understanding of her and her mum and dad and her boyfriend's parents and there's such kindness in it, as well as humour and lots of Italian, which I love. Yeah.
Okay, what was it like playing Zac Efron's mum?
A complete and utter delight.
I thought you were going to say disaster.
No, he's so easygoing and such a lovely person. And I wasn't going to watch myself. And I said to him, "Do you watch yourself, Zach, after a take?" And he said, "Oh God, no, I can't watch myself." You know, and some people don't say that.
Like, yeah.
Somebody else said, "I watch everything I do."
Yeah.
Martin Shore actually told me that when I was working with him. So you have to watch yourself to see what it is you do so that you can repeat it. But he has a completely different feeling. So again, like I said, you know, we have to find out what works for us.
Have you seen The Greatest Showman?
No.
Oh.
I must see it.
You must see it.
Absolutely.
It's so good.
I really want to. I love
you, Jack. It's fantastic. Yeah. Oh, it's great. The music's just gorgeous. Yeah. And Zach is lovely in it. It's jolly good. Yeah.
It doesn't surprise me.
You should watch it. Yeah.
He's got it all. Yeah. He's really wonderful.
Okay. With that in mind.
Yeah.
What's your favourite role you've played? Are you going to say Zac Efron's mum?
No. It was a very small role.
Yeah.
But it was a very nice time. I haven't done that much film, so it was very nice, you know, being in a film studio. It was great. The Pinewood. My favourite show? My favourite
role that you've played?
Role.
Yeah.
Favourite role? Oh, they're so... Each one, you know, so complex.
I think
Phyllis is pretty much up there at the moment.
Yeah.
Because she's so much richer than I'd expected. And... you know, being allowed to do it 8 times a week sometimes at the National, or a lot anyway,
yeah,
gave me a chance to revisit so many times and feel again and search a bit more. And I get her, and you know, it's very easy to look at somebody who looks fab and is kind of has that stature and think, oh, you know who they are.
Mm.
But actually, there's so much more to her. And it's great working with Zizi,
yeah,
as my younger Phyllis, because Zizi's incredibly intelligent. And,
I loved your folly together.
Stunning.
It was
very, very, very lucky to work with her like that as well. She's such an amazing performer. But when we were working out what Phyllis was like as a child and how did she get to be this,
We
stretched the boundaries, and it was really fun, and also it made so much more sense for her to have become the way she was and have that resilience inside her to keep going.
Yeah.
And she talks about hope at the end. So yeah, I really love her. I mean, obviously, you know, comic potential, you know, the robot, JC333, was an amazing, again, build, you know, it was a wonderful opportunity to build a character and to enter into the discussion with the writer, Alan Ayckbourn. It was amazing to be able to build it together, agree on so much, you know. It was like we were joined invisibly somewhere.
Yeah.
It was really great. Natalia in Month in the Country, which I did with Jonathan Kent, just momentarily, you know, it's just like a 3 months or something we spent on it, but it was an amazing experience and a great part. And I love Russian writing. I love Chekhov and Turgenev, who wrote that. And I went to Russia, you know, with Midsummer Night's Dream, and really appreciate that their knowledge of theatre and dance and opera. I don't know about musical theatre. I think it's becoming a bigger thing now.
Yeah.
But they are so steeped in their own history, and it's very rich to visit.
Yeah.
That country and see their artistic side, which, like us, have to exist alongside the political world and sort of echo it and stand back and watch it and form an opinion about it and work within it, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And yet we don't seem to be part of it in the same way, do we? I mean, we have to decide what we think, but we also have to be very balanced and work out why people decide to believe this or that.
Yeah,
and it's not because something's really, really bad either. It can be because they've had some experiences that make them believe that thing. So,
yeah, it's interesting.
You know, it is interesting and kind of ambiguous being an actor.
So, again, with that thought, final question. Do you have a role, a dream role, that you would still like to play, or do you have a role that you wish you could have played, which you're now possibly a little mature for?
Well,
dare I say,
I suppose if I'm really honest, when I did Romeo and Juliet,
yeah,
back in the day with Judi Dench, and it was after Carousel, and Nick Hyman was quite cross because I wasn't going to go to the West End because I wanted to do the Shakespeare, and he said, you know, I'd understand if it was Rosalind or something, but it's Lady Capulet, you know. And whilst I was doing that, I met my husband, Rupert, so it was a wonderful, heady time. And I learnt a lot, and that's all I wanted to do. I didn't want the stress of a huge character, but I did think that the character of Juliet was fantastic. But I have to say that my daughter, Matilda, Matilda Wickham, just played Juliet at Cambridge in the big professional theatre, and she brought out so much in Juliet that I hadn't thought of.
That must have been really bizarre, sort of seeing your daughter playing that role as well.
Well, I would have thought it would be bizarre, but yeah, it wasn't, because she wasn't her,
yeah.
She was Juliet.
Yeah, yeah.
She was everything you could ever wish, and new stuff. And I just felt, well, she ticked the box for me in a way.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
It was really amazing that she was playing it as well, because she's a very tall, strong, blonde. Mm-hmm. Well, she's not blonde actually, she's gone brown at the moment. very short hair. But she's, you know, she's a strong person, which you don't always get those people being cast as Juliet.
No.
I've never seen it. Oh, and it was much more moving because she seemed fine, and to watch her break was worse.
Yeah.
It was incredible. Yeah, so I'm pleased about that. That's the role.
The role
now.
The
that
role
role's
gone.
Done.
The role gone. Unless, I mean, there's no reason why they couldn't do a more mature version. I'm hoping that there is some truth in that, actually, that, you know, that being able to be Romeo and Juliet a bit more mature, although perhaps not the death.
I think Peter Hall, who I worked a lot with, bless him, he told me about Peggy Ashcroft when she was playing Juliet at the age of 50. And he said she used to let down her hair and speak. And he said she was 16.
Really?
Yeah. But I... No, I think it's fine.
Yeah,
I'm all right.
Okay, in that case, dream role.
Dream role. Oh, golly. You should have asked me this before, because it'll take me a long time to think.
That's all right.
Leave it with me and I'll come back to it whilst we're talking.
Come back to it. Well, in the meantime, tell us again about when your show is. So it's this next Sunday coming.
Sunday, Crazy Cox.
Sunday,
Monday, Friday and Saturday. So I'm topping and tailing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the show starts at?
Well, on Sunday it starts at 9:15.
Okay.
And that still has sort of 20 tickets left.
Yeah.
Monday it's at 7:15. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure we're sold out on Monday. And
excellent.
Friday and Saturday, the same. Friday and Saturday.
Yeah.
I don't know, there might be a couple left.
So there's a few tickets left, yeah. But it looks like Sunday's going to be your best shot if you want to come along. I will put a link into when we share the video on our social media. I'll put the link in for the tickets.
Lovely.
Quick dream roll.
I've played so many good ones already.
Yeah.
I think it's greedy. I think I'll just wait to see what comes up. I'm looking forward to playing. I'm looking forward very much to playing Caroline in Monogamy, which
uh-huh.
is a new piece.
Lovely.
It's a huge role.
And where's that?
That's going to be on tour and then coming into the Finsbury Park Theatre, the new theatre in Finsbury Park. So, yeah, that's
okay.
My next. That's my dream role.
Excellent.
Torben Betts play. A role in his play. That's amazing. Yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for coming
Thank
in. It's
you.
Been an absolute pleasure to
Thank
see you.
Thank you, Nikki. Cheers.
And
well
cheers. Yeah, cheers. Good luck with the show. As I say, next week at the Crazy Cox, and we'll put a link into our bio.
It's Sunday at the Crazy
Cox.
Yeah.
Cox. Yeah. Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Bye.